Newbees turn to ban. Radiant team ban. Newbees turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Radiant team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Newbies turn to pick.
Welcome back, everybody, here to our second game of this two-game series at Newbee up against Invictus Radiant Gaming for the DAC 2017 Championships. This is your second last series of the day here on the second stream of the second day of the second DAC.
What?
Of the only group stage.
10 seconds.
Actually, I'd say of the second group. This is technically the second group, right?
Radiant team pick.
A lot of seconds. A lot of seconds. But we're getting through to the first pick, into the second pick of Invictus Gaming. And it is Juggernaut and Magnus coming in for Invictus Gaming. So welcome to the classic buff up. While Newbee will get one of the most popular offlaners so far is the Centaur.
Jug again?
They gave up Mag Jug again?
XXL Godly.
He was amazing. And you're going to go Keeper of the Light Radiant as team your ban. Initial answer to this. At least the D push is pretty good from Noob by having that Keeper of the Light in.
But Magnus, how do you win team fights? It's all about winning team fights now.
Unless... up against, if the Magnus plays on the same level he played in game number one, yeah, I really don't know. Like, actually how you win that team fight.
Remaining.
I think, I don't know. I think there's very few cases where in Dota now you can't, like, if you don't have the ability to win team fights, you're not going to win unless
Newbies
you have, like, Naga.
Turn to ban.
Pretty rare. I guess Alchemist 2 kind of falls into that category. Sometimes Anti-Mage, but those are pretty abnormal, I would say, like, in. Actually. Pretty standard drafts, nothing. How do you deal with the
Radiant team
overwhelming
ban.
Team fight? Centaur Ags is pretty good. Keeper Ags also pretty good, but I mean, heroes dropped during the skewer was how fast it was.
Yep. I'm wondering if IG even just let the Rubik through. Like, okay, yeah, you want to go
remaining.
Rubik and Keeper of the Light? We're okay with that.
5 seconds remaining.
There's still some other decent things to steal, and yeah, they are going
to
let it through. They take out
ban.
The Naga as the fourth ban. I think Newbee actually played that early today, even though they didn't have a lot of success with it.
That's what you're scared of if you're Magnus. You're scared of
URP
you're,
into Song.
You're not scared of teamfight, I'll tell you that. So, you ban out the other avenues.
5 seconds remaining.
The anti-teamfight? The reset of the teamfight?
Yep.
Reserve
well, Centaur
time.
Kind of does off that anyway, right?
Through
Stampede. It's just as long as you can move.
Well, we've seen a lot of centaurs be very easy to kill. Normally, it's like, oh god, if we go on Centaur, we're going to... Maybe that minus one armor nerf was all it took.
Do you think Newbee as well are going to play the same battle they did before? Like, you put KP against XXS, and you just run that as your top lane. Because that was the fight they willingly put themselves into. They gave that Magnus so much space up on the top lane. They rotated to try and find kills, but didn't really work either. Like, if Earth Spirit gets through, Like, you're banning out Tinker again, so consistently, this is two times in a row NewB on their third ban have taken Tinker out against Invictus Gaming. With exactly the same opener as well.
I think that is one of... I remember seeing it first week.
Yeah. But it's like, do you still... Okay, they're going to take out the leader, too.
Radiant team pick.
It's like, OP just had so much space.
I think Shadow Fiend's still... Shadow Fiend, carrier for Magnus, and Skewer into Requiem for significant teamfight, a good tower hitter.
10 seconds remaining.
I think there are substitutions.
5 seconds remaining.
Glad you will have to change up their lineup from last time just a little bit.
Reserve time.
Get a little bit more of a glimpse into how they want to try and lane this up. But the easy assumption is Magnus off and Juggernaut safe. So we just need that first support, someone who's nice up against the Centaur.
Rubick themselves?
Possibly. Good against Stampede.
Yeah, you want something that's good against Stampede.
That's exactly what they do.
Yeah, Rubick.
Newbies, turn
he also has
to
low
pick.
Cast points. So... Newbie, what do they want? A hero that doesn't die to RP. Or a hero that can deal with RP. I still like Puck as an option versus Magnus. Because I think it's very hard to catch a Puck.
Remaining.
Puck is very good at disrupting the Magnus. Super annoying. Like, remaining. You coil and you get stunned after you skewer out. The silence, obviously.
Reserve
when was the last time that you remember seeing SC play a Puck?
I never.
Yeah.
Quap also might be an option.
Yeah, but we also flagged the other issues for a Queen of Pain. You catch her out with an RP and the way IG played it previously, they're just going to burst her out.
You need to stop the Magnus, though. Like, Invoker last game, yeah, he did a lot of damage, but he gets RP'd and he dies, and he can't really stop the RP from happening. What are you going to do, like, send forward spears to find a Shadowblade Magnus? I think Quap can actually, like, jump on the Magnus. Can't jump on the Magnus.
10 seconds remaining.
Quap can actually...
5 seconds remaining.
All the Magnus can just...
Newbies,
we are doing a rinse and repeat of the roaming supports from either side. So SK roaming for NewB and the Earth Spirit is back for Invictus Gaming.
Of course.
Yep.
Core Uno and Core Dos. All right.
10 seconds remaining.
Good versus Judge. Slark, I guess.
Oh, what? Wow, man.
They're actually doing it?
It's amazing when you're really right about something.
Wow.
For those that weren't tuning in to the wise oracle that sits next to me, looking at counter heroes against the Magnus and Wraith King is one of those.
That's actually amazing. I'm flabbergasted when they picked it. Normally, I'm like, oh, it sounds pretty good in theory, but, like, I don't. My line of thinking is much different.
Reserve time.
Except the once in a blue moon where they are like, hey, yeah, fuck it, let's go, Wraith King. Wow, Wraith King.
Yeah.
Dang.
The big man is up, and this doesn't actually allow NewBee to, if they want to,
they need to
do exactly the same thing again. Like you run the Wraith King on the offlane.
They SK Cuddle. They mega have to ban it. They just run Jug mid AM safe and Wraith King's awful.
But if Jug's going to still get the Diffusal Blade, it's not... He's still going to get what he wants out of the Wraith King.
It's not guaranteed, though. Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wraith King. I've been on fire sometimes with my draft picks.
And there's the Anti-Mage ban as well, so they protect their Wraith King. And now the mid laner. They went for the Invoker previously, and again, both teams have allowed him to go through the pool.
Puck, I actually still think is okay. I just don't know. It's also one of those.
And they're gonna stay with the Invoker.
Yeah, they need a scaling support. Pick. I don't know. Invoker
they need the Exor to work with the offlane. Like when you go for that for the multiple stuns on the offlane, you need to have that bonus damage because they don't really have it from what they've got.
They win the early mid, but you just lose out for RP later. This is what happened last game. Last game, yeah, sure, it was great. Same game plus Invoker, and then boom, RP comes online.
Five
and then
seconds
yeah.
remaining.
Lose all the team fight. I don't know.
Unless you switch it up, like...
Reserve time.
What do you mean switch it up?
I don't know, like, because right now I'm seeing NewB almost running the same laning phase as well, with this SK Coddle, Wraith King bottom lane, Centaur top lane. Let the one-on-one battle happen between Centaur as well as Magnus. Then just rotate in the SK when you think you can find a kill.
I think these dudes save a try. A safe lane try. Wraith King's not that great in aggro, because that hero really needs level. He's like, he's okay in aggro, but he's not amazing. I think you can just do like Wraith King same.
But if they look for the, because they still have the double stunts, right? Like, you still got the Wraith Fire Blast into the, but into the Barrow Strike with
melee
the Sunstrike.
Magnus, though.
10 seconds.
So Magnus, if you're not careful, he just gets back into town.
And Ember Spirit will be the final one up for Invictus Gaming, so.
Nice cleaver.
Yeah. Good combination with the Earth Spirit if they're going to try and find the kill in the mid up against the Invoker, but still requires SC to be slightly.
I did not see a think when I woke up this morning. I did not think I'd see Wraith King.
Why last, not, last why time, not Wraith King? What's so bad about him?
No one picked him. No one picked him even when Lone Druid was popular. Okay, and now that Lone Druid is falling off because of the nerfs, I would not think his talents are actually not. Played him a few times. They're just
10 seconds remaining.
Unsatisfactory.
Even his Ags upgrade seems very meh.
5 seconds remaining.
As good as a core. Kings do not deal with such worthless items. 4,200 gold, please. Anything that helps my team.
I will only take the glory and the riches for myself.
He has damage issues. You need attack speed. And is not necessary here. Juggernaut is not going to have, like, he hits, you're worried about Diffusal when they have a lot of attack speed and not enough damage. But when you have Empower, you actually hit harder, probably so hard that you're not going to. He actually does have an intel. If you're really scared about it, you can take it.
Let's get into the game. Invoker, do your little scout thing. This time, no TPs aggressively out from either side, including the pulled TP to burning. Also, just see, like, what was that set on U9? Alright, so he's still holding the Immortal. He's got his Immortal, the Autograph Blistering Shade by Kabu.
That thing is not one of the
Winter Blight though looks pretty sick.
Yeah,
it looked better in the display screen than this. Like, I don't know about the helmet either. It makes him look like a transformer.
I don't like the helmet.
Yeah,
Wraith King actually does not have that great. If only it were skeleton,
then he'd be a badass.
Yeah. But Skeleton King was also an issue in China because you're not allowed to show the bones, I believe. So it all got censored. That's why Klinks looks very different as well, and they have armor covering him up.
But we... Oh, are we on the... Is our... I don't think ours is...
No, ours...
Unscary.
Ours shouldn't be. We don't have a hero inside the game to actually test it on at the moment.
Go demo. Lifestealer. Yeah, just look at Lifestealer. Lifestealer has teeth. Yeah, he has teeth. And the other, he looks, yeah, he definitely looks normal. The Doom and the Lifestealer look really weird. I think it's actually scarier looking at them without teeth. It's like their mouths are like sewn or something like that. I don't know. It's not my favorite. I'm glad I play on the non-Chinese.
I hear that the Chinese voiceover is amazing.
Dude, it's hilarious. Hearing a Chinese dude do puck is great.
Wait, there's a dude that does...
I don't know if it's a dude or...
It sounds like a guy?
It's just a high-pitched same tone of voice as puck, except he's spewing out Chinese. It's hilarious. One of the funniest things I ever heard in my life is hearing SpongeBob done by a Chinese actor. I was in Taiwan, I was watching SpongeBob. It's so funny. The guy trying to do Patrick. Oh my god, Patrick is so hilarious. I don't understand a lot of Chinese, but what little I do understand, I just... oh my god, I was just cracking up. It was golden. I couldn't find it anywhere on YouTube when I was trying to find four.
Okay. Copyright must have been strict.
God,
struck.
So...
I now actually want to go check that out if I can find a copy.
Yeah, hopefully someone can link me. That'd be great.
My first time actually hearing like a different language do a show I really knew was when I heard the German version of Police Academy.
I don't know what that show is. Good.
You don't know Police Academy?
No. What's Police Academy?
It's like the classic movies of Commodore Lassard.
Dude, I don't know any old movies. Is it old?
Yeah.
I'm not an old movie
I think it's 1980s, I think?
Oh, I haven't watched anything before. I don't know. Miss Doubtfire is probably one of my oldest. Or like Land Before Time or something like
that. Okay, yeah, Land Before Time was epic. No doubt about that one, but not all the other ones that came after it. They did like 15 versions of Land Before Time. It was really, really, like, it was bled dry. That was almost as bad as Dogs Go to Heaven.
Didn't see that.
Another.
You're talking wrong, dude, buddy.
I'm sorry. The last TV series, like the older series, I was Lost or something like that. Yeah.
I watched Lost.
I did not.
SpongeBob SquarePants. Oh, man.
Where is IG off to? It looks like they're going to go for a bit of a wraparound. Newbee, last time they smoke up and they're actually going to do it again. They got the smoke over on Kaka. So yeah, they did this last time and then just pushed up and take the Radiant Rune inside the jungle. IG are not obliging them with a fight. They're actually invading the Newbee jungle to try and get that rune.
Wraith King is much weaker in lane than Weaver. So advantage of the Wraith King. That is one of Wraith King's biggest weaknesses, is getting pressured early on. I think he's strong at 1-3 and then...
Newbee really love contesting runes. Kaka, U9, and Fate gonna go around. Bubba actually just rolling bolted forward. So Burrow Strike forward. Here comes your Sunstrike and the Illuminate damage. There is your first blood going the way of Newbee.
Make that Wraith King work.
Yep. Remember. This is the downside about Wraith King. Like he'll actually get himself stunned back
chakra.
Up by the time he gets back in.
I forgot he has Chakra.
Yeah.
Chakra's really good because you can double stun. It's 8-second cooldown, and then with the 6-second reduction, it's 2-second cooldown, 2-second duration. So you have, like, double stun, and you actually don't need to go any mana items. You don't need to go Soul Ring. You don't need to go... you probably still go Stick, but you definitely don't need to go the Int talent. You can go the 15 damage instead. So, yeah, life's pretty good with Wraith King when you have Keeper. Actually, life's always good with Keeper.
Keeper is the hero, the ultimate support.
He is the ultimate support. Man, I just dream of having a Keeper.
IG's already switching their lanes up. I think they were also expecting Newbee to do exactly what they did last time by putting KP up on the top lane. Now KP, rolling boulder, gonna miss once again from the Earth Spirit, but with a spin, a quick TP out, KP will survive.
Damn, what a player.
And he goes back to the shrine, so he doesn't have to miss out on any potential experience.
He was so ready for that. And unfortunately for them, Boboka missed that. But had that rolling boulder connected, they definitely could have staggered the slows and stuns a little bit longer. So that no chance. Yeah. But very well played by KP.
They're going to turn this into a dual lane. The harassment from Keeper is a light to make life very difficult for the IG supports.
That's what you want to do as Keeper, though. You want to shove the lane in so there's no kill potential on KP. You can't kill KP if there's no creep wave. So that's I think, also why I think Keeper is one of the strongest heroes in the game right now, because he has this potential to make your offlane much, much stronger, because you just Chakra, Illuminate, Chakra, you know, pop a couple clarities, and just you secure level 3 for your offlaner just like that.
It's amazing how much space, too, that Kaka is going to receive. Like, you have the Magnus now coming over to try and contest him. I say contest him, he's actually got Skewer plus the Empower buff up. If Kaka's not careful, okay, he's gonna take the 2-minute rune. But you know what Magnus would love to do is try and kill him. But you're doing this, the SK's still gonna find a lot more farm. And what are you gonna do? Rotate supports up to the top lane to deal with that? Second you do that, you kind of almost sacrifice the Juggernaut on the bottom. Because KP just does this, the Illumina connects. Double Edge is available, but KP knows But one point up in double edge is not enough to kill off Burning at the moment. And another missed rolling boulder.
I still can't believe it.
I was actually stunned that they picked.
I wonder if you and I actually like this. That is a very polarizing hero for carries. If you ask carries, some love it, some hate it. It's one of the few ones that is like a love or hate.
It's like the carry that never ends, right? You can dive, you can do whatever you want.
Yeah,
there's gonna be random crit chances. But
people think that he's really boring though because you don't do that much, right? You just stun, you kind of lumber around, right click people. Like Weaver, you're super fast, you can move around the fight. Juggernaut is always fun to spin, and you feel like a god because you just spin these apartment waves, and Omni Slash makes you vulnerable. But yeah, for Wraith King, I don't know. Some people find it like super peaceful that you can just kind of farm and no one wants to mess with you because you have your ult. And some people are like, God, this is the most boring game in the world. Give me a hero that does something.
Kaka really just does not want that fight. Managed to make the time and effort to rotate into the mid to come in behind OP, but while Flameguard was
lane.
Up.
Another miss.
He missed the rolling boulder. Fate's going to give the Illumis a little bit of extra damage. KP didn't start his TP out. Instead, a quick Corp Stomp. No wand charges. No wand. He had Salvus, Wallace, Tangus. That no regeneration was the word I was looking for.
Wand is important.
Against this lineup, yep. Haste. Yeah, Kaka now with a haste through. OP. Flame Guard's back up again. And Kaka's not going to borrow strike underneath that T1 tower.
Too hard to burn strike anymore. Searing chain.
Udo's getting a lot of solo experience now on the top lane. Ikaka spending most of his time rotating. He may not be able to survive for this, however, as Provoker again. This time he'll go for the kick. Kaka will get the burrow strike off. A quick skill will slow him down and do that little bit of bonus damage. So SK will fall. Even if he was being a bit of a pain in the butt with the creeps.
Magnus, what a hero. So good at jungle, too. Like he is gonna snack at 5. They may even pop the shrine on the left side. Life's good for
Looks
Magnus.
To the mid. Where's that cold snap? Where's the control and OP? Kaka cannot reach him with a level 1 Barra Strike. SC has Sunstrike available, but really wants to have another stun to make that work. That's a 260 HP Ember Spirit.
Looks like he didn't want to expend.
Didn't really have a lot of mana to work with anyway.
Yeah, it's kind of the problem going the quads. Generally, you want these are the two spells you want.
Like this will work. This Sunstrike will work. Earth Spirit's going absolutely nowhere apart from down.
Back to base you go, sir.
You know the funny thing is, this is similar to the double stun combination we were having a bit of a chat about when we were kind of laughing about the faceless Windrunner offlane. This kind of feels very similar to like the double control, both provide the burst damage. Obviously KP's more melee than running a power shot, so it's double edge instead of the power shot.
You're comparing Centaur to Windranger?
Centaur to Lothrak. The SK is kind of filling the role of the Windranger, which is the initial stun. Of both teams, the mindset that scans just north and south of the mid lane.
OP is not level 6 yet. Just want to
smoke
make sure
break.
That quick.
Kaka's observer ward on the outside of the tree line breaks the smoke of Q and Baboka. Baboka. Rolling ball to forward. KP dodges it. Now your Borrow Strike. Wait for the Sunstrike. Hoof Stomp is down. Double Edge as well with the Illumin. They don't even need the Sunstrike. Kaka, however, maybe not enough life when Burning is able to get a nice crit to finish the job.
Jeez, that Arcana? What happened after he got that kill?
It imprints the ground.
He also just like sits still for a second, too. I wasn't part of that. Whatever he was trying to do on the console.
It was just the death of the crit. Anyway, that's still a 1-for-1 off trade. U9 is treading on CS. He's hit 50 CS in 7 minutes and 20 seconds. There's only one person staying anywhere near him, and that's OP. And now OP spending time outside of the lane. SC's all alone in the mid, about to complete up his hand of miners. So a perfect timing for him as well.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
They're getting so much out of this off lane.
This Raid King wants levels too. He just picked up a hand of Midas, so...
Midas is really important. You need to be able to get 12. You're like very vulnerable with level 1 ult. That thing cooldown is insanely long.
The attack! He doesn't miss up the hill. OP will be able to find that kill over on Kaka. I'm not certain though Invoker's going to be too happy about this, because SC picked up the hand of Midas, but the Courier is still busy up on the top lane. Efficiency-wise, a little bit off.
Just a tiny bit. If you think Black Hole cooldown is long, level 1 reincarnation.
That's awful. I'm surprised U9 actually skilled it. Instead of bypassing it. Or saving the point. I don't know if it's worthwhile actually having a trigger.
I think, yeah.
That's what most Raid Kings would do in the past.
It depends on how much faith you have in your... I think that your team is gonna always help you out no matter when and where you die the first time, then yeah, it's level 6, but
well,
yeah.
Taka's not really ready to give that kind of assistance. Like, if he had a blink dagger, I can understand the...
They'd have to commit a lot to kill him. How do they even start killing him once? They have to use a big ultimate, like, RP and a skewer back.
It's not even just like even killing him once is still fine. Like, burning through the reincarnation, putting it on cooldown.
I'd rather lose reincarnate than die.
Be careful. There's no RP actually skilled up for the Magnus. He went for this 4-2-1 build overall. Cool. Magnus.
Shockwave's really strong. Push out the wave with it. But yeah, I'm having RP.
Unusual.
Unusual.
But there's no team fights, right?
Yeah, and he needed a level 2 power. It helped him a lot being able to down those new. I don't think he's gotten
that fresh observer ward got scattered out by newbies, dire obs ward.
Well, momentum shifting back in favor of IG. Magnus doing his thing again. Still surprised that they gave it to him.
Yeah,
because one of the most unbelievable performances I've seen. But SCCC will get some extra gold, make up for that Midas, late Midas. Guess that Oddworld gold. Last game he went for Drop Scepter, I believe. Yule's very good for Ember to get rid of his thing. It's also good to deal with the Magnus. I actually think he's going more anti-Magnus than him.
U9 is here to fight, so IG are forcing with 4 heroes into this tier 1 tower, but with Illuminate spamming Keeper of the Light, the Sunstrike, and Illuminate will connect on OP. He's so low, the kick will create a little bit more space as SC and U9 all just have to stay exactly where they are. And they're bailing. They do half damage to the tower. Faith is able to repel them. Another player who just bypasses his ultimate. But very understandable with the Keeper of the Light.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah, definitely more so. Magnus. Magnus did pick up a level 8, so harm no foul for him. Looking at Ember, what do you actually build on the Ember? Veil, I suppose, is in this quick buy. He does have the Earth Spirits to synergize. I don't think of any other. I guess he can't really go wrong with Veil. There's not that much physical damage on the Dire side there, so I don't really know if he needs the armor. Playmail could also be kind of good too, just if we're running into your Battle Fury, not necessary. Maelstrom could be. I haven't really seen anyone really go like a right click, despite his right click talents getting stronger.
Yeah, but with the Ember Spirit going into the Mjolnir, yeah, still makes sense. So you can lightning shield yourself up on top of the Flame Guard.
Yeah. Be able to farm. Cast multiple remnants.
Face Observer Ward just scattered out, the Magnus moving up, and then again, so is the Dire Creep Wave. The face of the neighborhood, there goes your Stampede, just charge in. Illuminate will hit the money. Faith will take the kill, so TP support to come in at OP. He actually gets the double Searing Chains of both Kaka as well as U9. Boboko gonna miss a little bit again on that rolling boulder. U9 has to let the stun out. He triggered his one charge as well, so the mana is there for reincarnation to trigger. But when the Illuminate connects as well, the slow, they just couldn't go away. A secondary Illuminate's coming in. Boboko, he's so low, the Hellfire Blast will find the kill. But NewB unable to save the Wraith King on his second life.
Man, if only he were level 12 for that, it wouldn't have been so painful for him.
But he did lose the Magnus as well.
That could have been a lot better. Right? OP was really slow to pop his stick. He thought he had the mana for the Remnant. And he was like, SCC still gets a tower and already.
Yeah. Gets the tower, gets RP'd, goes invis, survives to fight another day. And this game appears to be a lot more problematic for Invictus Gaming. The rotations into simple pickoffs that they were able to find with the Magnus before, it just doesn't exist. And they need the Blink Dagger.
I think a lot of it is because of the Keeper. Like, they haven't been able to get any towers because the Keeper is just sitting there at the tower. So, Radiance before they could just seize your tower with the Juggernaut, you know, no problem. But now it's.
The second Obs will do it scattered out again? Give the money to Faith.
They need to use smokes for those.
Yep. But it's the fact the same Dire Observer Ward scattered out, both Observer Wards being placed.
I'll take that as tribute.
Boboko, maybe trying to drop an Obs Ward as they try and look for the Keeper. They see the Keeper.
They do now with the Illuminate out. But looks like NewB aren't really interested. Tark is forcing out the bottom lane. A quick scan by the Dire, looking into the tree line, realized no one's there, so SC have to turn this into a push game now. So more of a T1 for T1 tower trade-off. NewB are a little bit slow with their push, but they have the catapult still up and running. So it shouldn't take them too long.
Now a Yule's. Yule's is under attack. It's actually going to make Magnus much better. I know he was very fast on the Blink RP skewer last game, but this game, Yule's is very reliable in being able to stop a Magnus from destroying him.
That tier 2 tower is still falling. At the moment, NewB aren't in any kind of position to stop it. Kaka's too busy enjoying the bottom lane. And now the recall comes in. So Faith, bringing some friends back. And U9 will be the first one.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Or, it hasn't cooled down yet. He did take intel. Wow.
Yeah, he did. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Smoke up, jump up from the side. KPQ doesn't have the distance. AP has to blink himself into the tree line, starts cutting his way free with the Quelling Blade. But Stampede's available in and Kaga's very happy about this. Means he can pressure bottom lane a little bit more. Now you'll probably see Q jump down, Burrow Strike on, so pick him up, throw him down, Burrow Strike with a Fae Bolt, and in range of the tower. Kaga gets solo killed up by a Rubick.
What positioning. God. Wow.
He just made that work.
Impossible, I think, during daytime. He would have seen the TP in the back, but nighttime, you gotta use that small vision to your advantage. IG still looking to make some plays. RP has been up for quite some time, but
the timing to kill him. 13 seconds before you're going to have reincarnation back up again. So Searing Chains hold him in. There are 6-6 charges, and with Stampede, space can be created. So a Yule Scepter onto the Ember Spirit. Goodbye, Flame Guard. And oh, U9, he actually goes out to the Magnetized. Was he a second away from reincarnation?
He was 1 second away. Literally 1 second. Dire's middle tower has fallen. I think he popped the stick too early. I think what I see players do is, like, when you want an armlet toggle, you turn off your armlet, you pop your stick immediately, and then you turn your armlet back on before the tick happens from the magnet. But his problems were compounded because of the Magnetized. So, you know, going back to what you said about not skilling up the ultimate once, I think it would have been the play for him. Because he died twice, and then...
Just to accept his fate up on top lane.
And then he would have had level 2 reincarn for this particular.
Like, the only thing which probably helped that fight up on top lane was the fact that with the slow from his reincarnation, the second Illuminate did connect.
And he got that one kill on Earth.
Yeah.
Is it worth
Well, Fire Strike in from Kaka. Doesn't commit the epicenter, and rightly so, because OP jumps down. And then Sleight of Fist dodges the Hellfire Blast. Easy style points. NewB are going to go into their own smoke. They definitely know there's no vision. They've actually dewatered three Observer Wards in the last, I think, 4 minutes.
This is the time to hit the strike. When Wraith King gets level, gets to this point, level 12, almost with Link Dagger, it's time to start fighting. Magnus. You can't have him just farm a Midas and just get super out of control.
They find OP. Hofstomp can miss his target. OP's fine.
He didn't have any remnants at that exact moment. And another benefit about Wraith King is you can Roche very easily. You don't need Vlad. You don't really need anything aside from Wraith King.
Oh, I didn't keep Malacrity anyway.
Yeah, like Wraith King.
He's hitting about 270.
Light is good. Do they give it an SCP? Or do they give it to U9? I don't know. Probably SCP.
They always they give it to the Wraith King.
That is very surprising.
And they must really want to be using Wraith King as a punching bag on the front lines if you're going to give them Aegis.
Yeah.
Because it's kind of stupid, right? Especially in the later game, where your reincarnation will pop, and that's the first thing that triggers. So it's actually, is it that? Reincarnation pops first. Then the Aegis Immortal will trigger. Then you'll have reincarnation again. So basically, three times the Wraith King.
That usually only happens at level 8. When you're when you have your level 12, it's not really that beneficial to give him the age. I guess it depends on how YOLO you want him to play, but I don't know. I don't foresee, like, when I DC, like, why will we fight the Wraith King?
If they can.
Yeah, but I mean, that makes SCCC prime RP target. Prime.
We're actually getting like a 19 minute Midas now. Onto the Magnus.
Yeah, I think he had what? Maybe last.
It's like no one likes Echo Saber on this guy anymore.
Midas is important for the top. 90 GPM.
IG still waiting for some kind of opportunity. They've been very heavily grouped up, but they're also being grouped up on top of a Dire Observer Ward. Do you know which we're up against? Faith, maybe not realizing OP is down the bottom lane. Gets mass spirited by the Ember Spirit. And easily murdered.
Faith is not as good at hiding in the trees as
look at the spree. He had an EK 504 gold to OP for a spree just then.
Yeah. Keeper was really close to the scepter. I'm talking about like 100-200 blades.
I'll take that as tribute.
He has to back up a little bit more.
So U9, are you gonna go pick up your Blink Dagger? I guess you could pick yourself a stick for it right now. No more slots.
Yeah, it's Blink Dagger in the quick buy. Put the TP scroll into the stash.
I think you sell quelling, yeah.
That is what happens. And then, well, TP's up towards the top lane.
Because he does have the int talent, though, you still
mid lane Stampede's gonna be triggering at the moment. It's like OP was already killed off, so sorry, missed that one. And there was no instant follow up. So it was just the one hero kill. Burning starts his little spin and NTP. No stuns available. No basher build on the Wraith King to give that extra chance. Only chance.
I wonder what item he goes next. Probably Mjolnir.
On Wraith King?
Yeah. I see Blade Mail sometimes. I don't really like Jug or.
Would you not look for a little bit more lockdown from him? I don't know actually what do you get from that. Like a later MKB would make sense.
Lockdown means basher. I don't think you go basher right now. That is way too. I think no. If you go basher, you can't farm up that well. Like, he's having issues keeping up your network. You have to have a Midas to help that, but yeah, you still have to deal with, you know, Juggernaut and power on the opposite side.
What about things like Echo Saber on a Wraith King? Now, there's no instant buff you get from that, but potentially you could just have the increased chance to crit.
Echo Saber's too small for you have Midas, I suppose you go Midas.
So you just now just go for tier 3 items mainly.
Yeah, like Mjolnir, AC. After that, sometimes you need BKB if you're mana burn constantly. Sometimes you need Abyssal if you're having trouble walking down like a Juggernaut. I'd probably say Mjolnir, AC to Abyssal. Probably to build a maybe a heart to replace the armlet. You actually don't need BOTs in this game. Huge benefit that making a lot more viable.
Just pull him around wherever the hell he wants to go. For now, U9 is pushing out the bottom lane. Still, most of the support from NewB is headed to the southern side of the map, so the tier 2 tower on bottom lane is the priority target. And up on top lane, burning with the empower buff up, is going to be approaching the tier 2 of NewB safe lane very quickly. This kind of cleave raking just doesn't have.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
So he loses the push race. So Aegis Immortal is gone. It will time out.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's top tower
I mean, they couldn't have looked that. Trying to siege his best way. But IG, you know what to do when raking gets Aegis. Level 18 too, you still want to stall. But they can't do the shenanigans like they did before. Like, storing him in, it's not gonna work as well in this particular game. 40 second cooldown on ultimate is ridiculous. 40 seconds. With Aegis, it's really hard to kill him before his second ring comes up.
What do you actually go with U9? Like,
he's going Dezo.
I mean, like with the talent trees, with the later points. So attack speed or strength.
Wow, he went plus 50 with fire DPS. You only get 2 seconds of the damage.
Wow, I'm actually quite surprised.
So that just makes it 300 damage. Goodbye one. Sorry, bottom lane. I was too busy checking out those things. As KP dropping down quickly, they've lost two. The third one is U9, who will end up triggering off that reincarnation back to World of Living and then focusing onto OP. Finally gets the crit. Almost 600 for it. The RP from Mang's creates space, but better is the Blinding Light and Illuminate. The heals are kicking in, but Burning still with a triple kill. Looking for Red C. Does he find him? The Urn Charge is doing the work. The Shockwave will miss its target. But does the Urn have enough damage with the silence? He's down to 44. He will survive. SC is away. Will purge up his Spleen Dagger. The Shook Wave!
What?
So close!
Wow.
SC will get recalled and then illuminated back up. A little bit of life and then triggering Shrine as well.
I can't actually believe that XSS was so close. That's some good presence of mind there.
Woo! Run the movement speed, start the pings on the ground. This is where he's going. This is where he's going.
I don't actually like Dezo that much on Wraith King just because it's a mid-tier item that you're going to replace later. I think like Maelstrom helps you a lot more into the later game, but it is really good at killing the Jug while he spins. The thing is, I don't think Burning's going to be spinning. Like, you're not going to have that much uptime. Zero.
Do you even think NewB gets into the late game as well?
They're going to at this point. But one of the biggest problems with Raking is getting kited, which is why we skip build a lot. And I think Mjolnir also helps the issue of you getting kited, because you're going to be taking down from like Magnetize, Flame Guard, whatnot. So your Mjolnir is going to proc constantly. If he were to. Desolator, not my preferred build, but he is going for Dezo into the AC combination. Heavy, heavy, heavy right there.
Yeah, that to me just feels like NewB, you really want to go high ground, and he has to be the main line tank for that. Skewer out, got to find Karka, a quick silence, and then Stampede away. Mana leak over on Provoker, that's problematic. Already going to get stunned up as he tries to rolling bolt around. But Stolen Stampede allows IG to easily retreat.
If they're out, NewB know that they can do Roche at will, but
Fate is trying to make it completely dark on the map for IG. Get their own observer wards down, having that early gem. It's only one real observer ward on the map. In fact, it is the only observer ward up for the Radiant side at the moment. Sitting on the top lane. couple more now that Rubik has picked him up. But he's only got one observer to work with. Hard to keep tabs on where Newbee is moving. You just don't have the obs up, and in fact, Newbee under the cover of smoke, obs wouldn't even help you for this. That Dire Observer would see so much. The jump forward, the stun over on Burning with the Hawk Stomp as well. They need the kill, but a four-man RP! Faithful creates Faith, but into the Omni Clash! Newbee! They'll lose everything! Reincarnation will trigger, but Burning, he did his job. Now he has to let OP do the rest of the work. The kick can fly through. They have to hold U9 in position, and they're able to do so. Burning will pick up a double kill, but a perfect RP into the sweetest bit of damage you could hope to do against Newbee.
Yup, that Omni Slash. Must have felt good for Burning right there.
Just before that fight began, too, he spent his money. Like, if that didn't work, they could have been, like, in real issues. But he bought the Bash before that fight began.
Oh, that was
4.6k damage he got.
They were so close to killing Burning. But that health talent saved his booty. Actually, I don't know if he was below 165, but he was pretty close. He was probably in like low 200.
He was low. I think that's enough.
They actually didn't get Roche. NewBee did. Yeah. Now they're in a pretty bad spot. Invoker's died a couple times now. Wraith King just died a couple times.
This one, Wraith King was meant to come online. Be really powerful, and it's IG winning the fights. But it's also the respect you have to give to the Magnus. Like, that four-man RP. NewBee were committing so heavily in to try and kill off Burning before that fight began. And then the RP created all the space in the world. And the unsung hero in that was OP. Like, he was in there as well. I believe he actually got a four searing chain off. He got a huge searing chain off.
Getting four-man RP like that is just a little bit too much tunnel vision onto the Juggernaut. Burning's important, but not that important. Even if they had killed, let's say they had killed Juggernaut, would they have been able to survive that? I suppose they would have. Burning did like 7,000 damage in that fight. Kind of everyone's HP.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Alright, so IG. Only one remaining out of tower now for them to remove of newbies. But they're also being pressured up on the top lane. KP gave it a little bit of a nudge, trying to create a little bit more space for himself to finish up his own Aghanim Scepter. They have an opportunity to kill off Kaka on the bottom lane. Burning has that Blink Dagger available, so a quick Sandstorm and skewer down over into the tree lines. Kaka, they blink, they'll find him, no bash. Two hits from Burning and no joy.
I will not forget this.
Pretty low chance, 50% chance.
You still live on hope. There's your Abyssal Blade now being completed up, so Juggernaut now has a fully completed Abyssal Blade. There is no chance anymore.
It's so bad for the Invoker now. Invoker, I'm still not the biggest fan of the Invoker picks.
This could work nicely. OP, no protection for him. Perfect Hoof Stomp double edge, and thankfully your Scepter. There was no way to really have a flame cut up, and that's 70 seconds where the Ember Spirit is down. He was buying his Lincoln Sphere. So, NewBee actually had the opportunity to fight here.
How do they see him?
Observer Ward in the lane, I think. And he was being stalked by the SK. The Observer Ward's deeper, like a long way down. They can see the rest of IG posturing. So, U9 to the front lines, the tank with the 40 second cooldown on the ultimate. With the Lycra ready buff up as well, he hits pretty damn hard. Not that long until daytime, so 15 seconds until daytime is up. Newbee's push becomes a lot better at that point. Abyssal Blade gonna be committed. The Wraith King, not looking too healthy. Hellfire Blast will be stolen, and Wraith King, very, very low. The Urn will tick him out. Remember again, though, he's gonna have that off cooldown pretty soon, so they have to murder him with the Omni Slash. KP jumped in as well. He takes so much of the extra damage. Burning will find the double kill. And Newbee on the retreat once more. TP out to the side lanes, TP back to base.
Looks like Wraith King might not beat the counter.
may have actually been the counter. The problem is, like, the position they had around that, that ancient fight just... It bit him in the ass.
That was rough.
It's been a long day, too.
Well, now they can get some tower damage in onto the T3. Despite Keeper's best efforts to keep him away, there is still 30 seconds to the grave for Wraith King burning and snapping.
And Wraith King can't really fly. Oh, baby, the RP! They caught out the Invoker! SC is gonna go down. Wraith King and Invoker both have buybacks, but 82 seconds without the Invoker.
XXS just finds the best RP.
He just finds the best of everything with Magnus.
Kaka tried so hard to stun them. But he is the fastest Magnus I've seen. He'd be really good in like a Wild Wild West duel. So he's so quick on that.
There goes your mid melee, Rax.
We're talking about an instant stun. Yep. No cast point on Burrow Strike and still was not able to get it off before the skewer and SMG. Oh god, I'm dead.
He's too good. He's just too good. And they already want to go back in again.
No,
he doesn't even care. Like, the Observe Ball gives him all the information he needs. He knows he can do the Blink Skewer and drag KP back. Because KP farming on the side. Can he get closer to Kaka? Kaka hiding inside the Sandstorm as you see burning, running towards him.
It's a little risky, though. They don't have ultimates up. No RP, no Aegis. So remember what happened last time when SEC bought back and destroyed them with the Invoker? That very same thing could well happen if they're not getting burning will DC tower with the tower.
Spin, get the kill, get back, and then just push bottom lane. Invoker's back to the world of the living. He actually took the extra tomes of knowledge, which spawned up, so he's now only one level shy of 25.
Look at the gold grab. Biggest lead was possessed. Newbee, 5,000, about 10 minutes. IG, 6,000 right now.
Yeah, actually creeping up to about 7,000. It's just bumping up and up and up for Invictus Gaming. And
it's the same story as last game. They won the lanes, they got Sunstrike kills, and then Invoker gets RP'd and just can't do it. Their other core, Wraith King, is a little bit more tanky than the Weaver, but still.
This IG smoke, the positioning they're gonna have, like, they're smoked up beautifully. Now Newbee, they get revealed quickly, and it was the Observer Ward. They get close enough to see him. Faith, the jump up, the kick is on the wrong target. A quick stampede is disengaged, but KP blinks in to go into the fight. He'll take the entire Omni Slash, so Burning will find that quick kill, and then the bash. U9 is isolated from the rest of his team. The RP on the back lines. Invoker can't do anything. This could almost be the game if they lose the Invoker as well, skewering him back. I suppose buyback is available, but Burning has a triple kill. You lost your mid melee, Rax. You can push in through mid and go towards top, but IG, they own this map. They own every fight. They own Newbee's ass.
Oh my god. That Yule's on Earth here too. Yeah, he might have missed his spells, but he Yule's on Keeper and started off the fight. That was really what killed it for the Juggernaut. Spinning out. No big deal.
Good spin in time. Oh, Kaka, Kaka, you can't go out to that. Q throws him down, actually uses him to stun up U9. The stun strike will connect. The Wraith King reincarnation will trigger. Back to the world of the living.
That was a nice play by Burning. He tried to blink away with his main hero.
Cobble's dead. Cobble's dead. Actually, no, there's no detection. So the range creeps won't continue to attack into it, so the Rubik will fall. And Cobble will barely survive.
And there's two big buybacks. Invoker and SCCC. One more fight, they should be able to take this game home. Respawns in 1 minute 22 seconds. Good old Roshan.
Right in time for, well, who do you give that to? Now you got the BKB over on Juggernaut. He's still fairly tanky.
Jug's the tower. I think almost all the time you give to the tower. Ember Spirit is like, he's good with AP, so he shouldn't really die that much, and he's not going to be at the highest score for. You need to be able to kill the Juggernaut, and he's so strong that you can't ignore him. Sometimes you want to kite the hero with Aegis and kind of ignore him, save him from last. That's what would happen in breaking break. But when Juggernaut with Empower is hitting you, it's something that you have to do.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Refresher is up for the Magnus. It took 37 minutes for it to arrive.
Let the psh fly. How do you actually make the RP sound?
Can you do it for me?
I don't know. I don't know how you'd actually make it when you know.
I'm sure a beatboxer would have.
Yeah, but we're not that skilled.
I don't know.
That sound would still be good enough for me. Darker, they see him in the tree lines. The Shadow Blade. They don't. He's just around the corner.
He's trying to pop smoke. I think they've already blown through him. Oh, there's U9.
Yeah, right on top of the Observer.
There's a gem on KP.
Here comes your kick. The RP's down. Skewer him back over. So U9 will be isolated for the moment. Remember, you've still got that secondary RP, but the double barrel strike, OP, plus the Earth Spirit taking out of the fight. The solo Omni Slash onto U9. He is gone for so long, almost a minute and a half down. Tornado will create a little bit of space, but FaZe having trouble running out. He's their primary D push. He cannot die, but Magnetize is a real pain in the butt, especially when Hellfire Blast will be able to connect. It'll be the final bit of damage. They hold the RP. SC is gone. That's really the game. You've got no Invoker for 2 minutes. You've got no Rage King, and NewB will admit defeat. Invictus Gaming, on the back of what has been a superb Magnus display, will take the series in a landslide.
It dumps it by XXS. Oh my god. Even burning on Magnus Jug is the strongest 1-2 punch I've seen from heroes in this tournament so far.
NewB gave it to them twice. Like, it wasn't even just a...
They thought they had the counter. Well, Wraith King, I actually...